Wow, what a year it's been for Surfrider Foundation. To all of our members and supporters, a huge thank you for being part of an incredible 2021. The support from our ocean-loving communities has been simply incredible and has helped us to do what we do best, protect our coastlines, ocean, and playground. We kick things off with a bit of a bang down in Victoria, joining other local community groups on the steps of Parliament House to oppose gas in Westernport Bay. Thousands of signatures and postcards were sent through to the State Parliament in a phenomenal show of opposition to the project. And within weeks, the project was scrapped. Between April and May, we held four huge paddle out events for our Stop PEP 11 campaign. The Northern Beaches, Central Coast, Newcastle and Byron Bay communities came out in force to show their opposition to a project that threatened the most populated coastline in Australia. It was without doubt a busy month, but with local support from businesses to musicians, professional surfers and even world champions, the voices of our communities were heard. We then followed this up with a successful series of Stop PEP 11 community town halls in July, with scientific experts, economists, local politicians and high-profile athletes educating the local communities on the impacts that offshore oil and gas exploration would have on our communities, coastlines and our beloved ocean. The Preserve Gnarabup campaign of our Surfrider Foundation Margaret River branch has been holding it down in the west, with events all year opposing a monster hotel development on a sensitive clifftop overlooking the world-famous main break surf spot. Back in August, our newest Surfrider Foundation branch down in Tasmania began campaigns taking on multiple gas projects and the proposed expansion of commercial fish farms, which threaten the local economies and health of marine life in the region. Think we're done there? Hell no. The Northern Beaches Council built a wall on Collaroy Beach, which threatens the very future of a world-class break. So we made sure that that made news with a Hands Across the Sand event, while our awesome Central Coast branch continued their battle for some idiotic plans of a vertical seawall on their very own beach in Wombril. Moving down the coast, our South Coast branch was heavily involved in a massive win for the local community, saving Killalea National Surfing Reserve from a proposed 200-seat conference centre, restaurant and eco-cabin facility. A special mention goes out to our dear friends Jack McCoy and Paul McCartney for dedicating not one, but two music videos to Surfrider Foundation in a legendary creative partnership, which saw some of the world's best free surfers going nuts to the sounds of sweet rock and roll. And as we've since found out, the relentless pressure and opposition from our communities over the last year in particular led to the government finally scrapping the PEP 11 project once and for all in a monumental win for all ocean lovers. Now, while it's been a mammoth year for us here at Surfrider Foundation, the job is far from done. As our society's destructive impacts on our oceans and coastline become more and more apparent, our responsibility to ensure the health and prosperity of our oceans also becomes more important. So we're calling on you, our ocean-loving friends and family out there, to sign up to our membership program for 2022 and get yourself involved in one of our local Surfrider branches. The upcoming year is ours to make it a memorable one, and we'll be jamming it packed with events and campaigns to make sure that your favourite beaches are surfable for years to come.